How's it, guys? Gus, your African plant hunter here, and I'm back again with another episode on this remarkable plant, which is the flame lily, Gloriosa superba, the national flower of my home country, Zimbabwe. And I'm standing, by the way, here at my home, in a place called Christian Bank, just north of Harare in the Mazoe district of Zimbabwe, for those of you who'd like to know. So this plant, which is really remarkable, contains a compound that has been used. The compound is called colchicine, and it's been used to treat various ailments for, apparently, we have records, historical records of its use for 3,500 years. Isn't that incredible? So it was first licensed as a drug in the US in 1972 for the treatment of gout. And it's been licensed and investigated more recently for various other treatments, antiparasitic, anti-tumor, cancer, and anti-inflammatory. So let's talk about the mode of activity. Now, this mostly comes from the tuber, the root and the tuber, they're different things, of this plant. Now, colchicine, it inhibits polymerization of microtubules. And what it does is it binds to tubulin, which is one of the main constituents of microtubules. And availability of tubulin is essential to mitosis, and therefore, because colchicine inhibits polymerization, it effectively functions as a meiotic or a spindle poison. Now, this may sound technical, but it's all good news. Since one of the defining characteristics of cancer cells is a significantly increased rate of mitosis, this means that cancer cells are much more vulnerable to colchicine poisoning than are normal cells. So I'm just stating there's no magic cure here just yet, but this is work that's been going on for a while, and it really does look as if there are significant opportunities for employing colchicine in the tumor inhibition. In terms of inflammation, there's been work done on inhibiting inflammatory activity in rats, and that I don't think has gone on to human studies yet, but it's certainly traditionally used for inflammation and wound healing, and it's highly, highly, highly likely that it's going to be effective pharmaceutically. Another thing, talking about colchicine in the tuber, but the leaf of Gloriosa superba, the flame lily, has been used, a leaf extract, to display significant anticoagulant properties, inhibiting thrombin-induced clotting. Now, again, a hypercoagulable state is often associated with cancer. So due to the recognized link between cancer and hypercoagulation, medications able to treat cancer that also have an antithrombotic or anticoagulant activity are ideal as chemotherapeutic agents. So that's another really, really, really exciting element in the story here, that it's got a compound in it that treats the tumors, and then at the same time it's got a compound in it that has anticoagulant activities. Now, I'm not even going to pretend that I'm an expert in cancer. I'm not a doctor. I am an ethnobotanist, so what I'm talking about is what I've read from other people. So I don't want to give any false hope that, you know, this is a magical cure or anything. I'm just sharing this, that it's really interesting that this plant has these properties, and that colchicine is such a well-known pharmaceutical ingredient. So, all right, I think that's enough on colchicine. I'll be back next time with another episode on this remarkable plant, Gloriosa superba, the flame lily. I'm Gus, the African plant hunter. Thanks for watching. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.